He said that, Mawlana Sahib, this voice is also ni'mat from Allah. He said, when I was in the pop industry, sing songs, so they used to tell me that you must sleep 8 hours a day, otherwise your voice will not be proper. So he said, we had to sleep 8 hours a day. But then when I did tawbah and I started going in tabligh jamaat, we hardly get any sleep. We have to do bayan, running around, and on top of that, reading nasheed as well, because when people hear that Junaid Jamshid is here, then you have to read nasheed. And alhamdulillah, I keep reciting, and alhamdulillah, my voice is okay. This is barakat of tabligh jamaat. So, sleep is very important to have proper voice. And in Ramzan, we get lack of sleep as well. So these are the things that take effect on the throat. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wasallam had a beautiful voice. And he started reciting, وَالنَّجْمِ إِذَا هَوَى مَا ضَلَّ صَاحِبُكُمْ وَمَا غَوَى وَمَا يَنْطِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَى إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا وَحْيٌ يُوحَى. Beautiful tilawat. When he completed the surah and he came upon the verse of sajda. أَفَمِنْ هَذَا الْحَدِيثِ تَعْجَبُونَ وَتَضْحَكُونَ وَلَا تَبْكُونَ وَأَنْتُمْ سَامِدُونَ. And the command of sajda. Hazrat Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wasallam went in sajda and all those behind him fell into sajda too. Muslims and mushriks alike, they all did sajda except for one person. He took a little bit of soil and touched his forehead with it and threw it back and he said, Yakfini haza. Ya Allah. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, the narrator, says, I saw him afterwards killed as a kafir. Had he done sajda, perhaps Allah would have given him tawfiq to embrace Islam. But his takabbur and haughtiness and pride was such that it stopped him from going into sajda. This is why, you know, shaitan was extradited from Jannat for refusing to do one sajda to Adam alayhi salam. And today, we as Muslims, how many sajdas we miss out? How many namaz we miss out? Think for yourself, check your iman. Pray your namaz properly, do your siddhas properly. One riwayat in Sahih Muslim says about siddha tilawat, when the son of Adam recites an ayat of sajda and goes into sajda, shaitan goes to one side and bites his teeth and cries. He said, woe unto him, meaning himself. Ibn Adam was told to do sajda. He did it. He will get Jannah. I refused and I will get fire. So, sajda tilawat's importance is understood over here. That sajda tilawat takes a person into Jannah. Therefore, when you read an ayat of sajda, it is advisable to do sajda instantly. Though you have to pause your tilawat for a little bit, but don't worry about that. Put it on one side and go into sajda. Close the door. So go in sajda straight away. However, if you were to delay the sajda until you finish your tilawat, your surat, or your para, or your juz, and do your sajda after that, that is also possible. It's allowed. It's okay. And if you wanted to delay all your sajdas until the end of your khatam, it is allowed but not advisable. Because we might forget. We are human beings. Sometimes we do forget. So because of that risk of forgetfulness, and missing out, if we miss out, then we will be questioned on the day of Qiyamah for missing out a wajib. Siddhay Tilawat, according to the opinion of Imam Abu Hanifa, rahmatullahi alayhi, and his ashab, is wajib. Imam Shafi'i, Imam Malik, Imam Ahmad say it's sunnat, but sunnat should be done as well. Whether it's sunnat or it's wajib, Imam Abu Hanifa said it's very emphasized highly emphasized and it's wajib, you must do Shaddai Tilawat. So the answer to the query is that yes, you can delay the sajda a little bit, but it would not be as advisable to delay it too much. Continuing with the subject of reciting Quran, there are certain adab of tilawat. If we follow those adab and etiquettes, then we will get maximum benefit, maximum barakah, maximum sawab. We see that mashayikh akabir, they used to revere the Quran a lot. Quran has said, ذَلِكَ وَمَنْ يُعَظِّمْ شَعَائِرَ اللَّهِ فَإِنَّهَا مِنْ تَقْوَى الْقُلُوبِ. Whoever respects those things which are specially connected to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, known as sha'ira, sha'air, then this is due to piety in his heart. This is a sign that he has taqwa in his heart, and that is why he is revering and respecting those things connected to Allah. Quran is Allah's, is connected to Allah. Respecting the Quran is a sign that you have ta'zeem and respect of Allah in your heart. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will reward you for that respect which you show to the Quran. And Salaf used to respect it, they used to love it. And you know, Ikrimah used to take Quran in his hand and he would say, Haza kalamu Rabbi, Haza kalamu Rabbi, Haza kalamu Rabbi. This is the kalam of my Rabb. This is the kalam of my Rabb. This is the kalam of my Rabb. So is Quran is Allah's words, Allah's kalam. And the more you respect it, the better. This is why when you hold the Quran, we should touch, hold it with wuzu. And when we finish tilawat Quran, we should kiss it. Because kissing is a sign of love, muhabbat. We kiss our parents, grandparents, our asatiza, mashayikh, our elders on their foreheads. This kiss is a sign of love, muhabbat, ta'zeem, respect. So if you have respect for the Quran, then kiss the Quran when you finish and place it on a high place to show your reverence for the Quran. This respect and this adab will save your iman as well. I mentioned the story narrated by Peer Zulfiqar Sahib Naqshbandi, hafizahullah, in his Mawa'iz, about this young man who went to study in the USA. Now, as with others, everyone, we succumb to our desires. He fell in love with this girl, non-Muslim, and they started going out together. He proposed for marriage. She said, well, I am a Jew, you have to become a Jew. And he said, okay. He changed his religion. And he married her. Now, they started living together. Tabligh Jamaat Satis would go for gush to his house. He told them not to go to his house anymore. So they stopped going there, but they kept making du'as for the young man. They started living, time passes by, few weeks, months pass by. Now, he had a copy of Quran, which he had kept on the top of a wardrobe somewhere. So one day he comes back from work and he notices that the Quran is not there. So he asked his wife, you know, where is that book which I placed over there? And she said, oh, that book was there for a long time. Nothing was, you know, it was doing nothing. It was all getting dusted. So I was cleaning everything. So I threw it in the garbage. And he said, oh, you threw it in the garbage? It was the Quran. And he rushed. And he took the Quran. Astaghfirullah. Quran Sharif. Quran Sharif was thrown in the dustbin. And she looked, saw everything, and she said, oh, that means you've not forgotten your religion, you still got love for your religion, you've not changed properly. And then she said, it's either me or your religion, your Quran, You can't stay with me like this. So he said, Bad. Talak, talak, talak. I don't want to stay with you. He left her. Next morning, you know, in masjid, he was the first in the masjid behind Imam Sahib. So Imam Sahib was shocked. He said, okay, bhai, kya hua? And he related the whole story. Now, what saved his iman, you tell me? His love for Quran. Deep down his heart, he had the love for Quran. Deep down his heart, he respected the Quran. The respect for Quran, the love for Quran, saved his iman. And you will see many cases of this type of respect. Not only saving iman, elevating ranks in Jannah. There was this king from our Indian subcontinent. He ruled, he was a nice person. Maybe it's regarding Sultan Mahmud Ghaznavi or someone else. After his death, you know, he was seen in a dream by one of the mashayikh who asked him, how are you, in what condition are you? And he said, Alhamdulillah, Allah forgave me. I'm in a very good condition. MashaAllah, you are a nice king. You did a lot of good things because of that. He said, no, it wasn't that. It wasn't that. It was because once I was traveling and we stayed at a hotel, motel. And I was given a very nice room. I went in the room. I lied down. But then I noticed towards my feet, there was Quran Sharif. So I looked at the Quran Sharif. Oh, Toba Toba, Astaghfirullah. My feet are towards the Quran. How can that be possible? I can't do this sort of bi'adbi and disrespect of the Quran. So he said, I immediately stood up. Now, I couldn't sleep on the other side. Perhaps maybe there was a Qibla on the other side. So he wanted to disrespect the Qibla either, or some other reason, Allah knows best. So he said, I just, you know, sat there and dozed off without stretching my feet. And I spent the night in that manner. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loved that adab of mine so much that because of that one night which I spent restless and I didn't want to stretch my feet towards the Quran, Allah forgave me because of that. And Allah gave me all these high ranks which you are seeing. This is the adab and respect for Quran. Quran is Quran, it's Allah's words. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves those who love the Quran. Imagine how much He will give to those who love the Quran and then who recite it as well. And especially those who recite it with beautiful voice, beautiful tone. Among the Qurra, we see Al-Qari, Al-Muqri, Hamza, Al-Zayyad, who used to go around from morning till evening teaching kids Quran. And he's one of the seven Qurra from Sabaqirat. And he once saw a dream in which he saw Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to him, Hamza, I love your tilawat. You got a very nice voice, very nice tune. Come on, recite Quran to me. Allahu Akbar. So he said, I started reciting Quran from Alhamdulillah Sharif and Surah Baqarah. And I recited the whole Quran up to Al-Nas in the presence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And at two places, Allah corrected me and said, no, read it like this. In his qiraat, he used to read, Wa inna ikhtarnaka. So Allah said, no, read, وَأَنَا اخْتَرْتُكَ. So he said, وَأَنَا اخْتَرْتُكَ فَاسْتَمِعْ لِمَا يُوحَى. And another place. So he said, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Hamza, you recited beautifully. You go around teaching people my Quran. I love you. My angels, my malaika, bring a special crown for Hamza and a special belt. You know, belt around the waist, boxing, wrestling, heavyweight champion belt, and it's got diamonds and everything. So a beautiful, beautiful belt was brought, which had nice diamonds and rubies and various colors and shining. And a beautiful crown was brought. And Allah said, put this crown on his head for his beautiful tilawat recitation, and that belt around his waist for his running around all day and teaching Quran for free. So when you revere, respect Quran, this is what you get. Among the Qurra is Qari Nafi'. When he used to recite Quran, special khushbu of musk used to come out of his mouth. And at other times as well, people used to ask him, where do you get this ajeeb special khushbu from? And he said, nothing, I just recite Quran as much as I could, and I teach, and I spend my whole life in teaching. One night, I saw the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in my dream, and he kissed me. And since then, this khushbu is coming out from my mouth. So when you attach yourself with the Quran, Allah blesses you so much. One Qari used to love the Quran, respect Quran, and he used to recite with beautiful voice. And one night he sees the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in his dream, who addresses him by his name, saying, "Anta kada wa kada, and taqra'u al-Qur'an bi sawtin hasanin, jazakallahu khairan." You are so and so, you recite Quran with beautiful voice, jazakallahu khairan. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is telling him in the dream, may Allah reward you with the best of rewards. This is all because of his love for Quran Sharif. So we see from day one, we hear about Ikrimah, the student of Ibn Abbas, who was a great mufassir of Quran. And in spite of being that great mufassir, he has so much love. He doesn't lose the respect of the Quran by attaching and always reading Quran. The more you read, the more respect will increase. So he used to say, "Haza kalamu Rabbi, haza kalamu Rabbi, haza kalamu Rabbi." We need to bring that respect in us. Respect the Quran. Have adab of the Quran. Don't lose your adab of the Quran. Don't touch it without wuzu. You know, read it with wuzu. Hazrat Shaykh Nawarullah Murqadahu mentions some adab of tilawati Quran. He says, there are rules of external reverence and rules of internal reverence. Rules for external reverence is, when you want to read the Quran, perform wuzu and sit facing the Qibla in an extremely dignified manner. Wuzu se padho, Qibla ki taraf muh karke padho, adab ke saath padho. If you can place Quran on a high place, like a patla or rihal or something, place it on there, on a table, and then recite. My mother was telling me that my father used to read a lot of Quran, and he always used to place Quran on a rihal. And he had his old Quran from many, many years in which he became hafiz. It's still at my mom's house. And it's the pages on the side have worn out. It's extremely old brown papers. He used to keep a rumal inside it. And then that handkerchief, he would put it as his nishani and sign. And he used to read lots of Quran. Maybe, I don't know, in the morning he gets up, he keeps on reciting, 8-10 juz. I remember when we were in Dewsbury, he used to recite Hizbul Azam loudly. Especially at iftar time, he would be reciting Hizbul Azam loudly. So everybody can hear, you can say Ameen as well, and join him in the dua. So respect, place it on a high place, and then read it. And this is why, alhamdulillah, the last action of my marhum father was listening to Yasin Sharif. He listened to the whole of Yasin Sharif, and فَسُبْحَانَ بِيَدِي مَلَكُوتُ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ وَإِلَيْهِ تُرْجَعُونَ. And then when that finished, it was with translation, tarjuma. My niece, my brother Abdul Hafiz's daughter, put it for him on the mobile, and he listened to whole Yasin with tarjuma, and then he stood up for istinja. And as he was going to the toilet, he fell, he had brain hemorrhage, and he passed away. So the last action of his life was listening to Yasin Sharif. So respect for Quran, adab for Quran, muhabbat for Quran. Put it on a high place when you sit down to read, and read it with wuzu facing Qibla. Number two, do not read very fast. Read with the measure and correct pronunciation. Makharij. Take out the makhraj properly and with measure. Number three, try to cry. Even if you have to compel yourself to do so, try and cry. Even if you have to force yourself to cry, but try and shed a few tears whilst you are reciting. You know, people used to cry when reciting the Quran, inside namaz, outside namaz as well. They are reciting and they are crying, tip, tip, tip. This is why you must have seen on videos in Haram Sharif, Taraweeh, people from the Indian subcontinent, they don't understand a word of Quran, but when Imam Sahib, Sheikh Shuraim Sudais are reading, they are crying, tears flowing from their eyes. So Quran has that effect of bringing tears to the eyes. To try and weep, try and cry. Number four, the response to the ayat of mercy or punishment should be as explained above. When you read an ayat of mercy, then pause for a moment. Ask Allah for His rahmah. Ayat of Jannah, ask Allah for Jannah. An ayat of punishment, azab, anger of Allah, then seek Allah's protection from that azab and from that ghazab and anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number five, reading should be in a low voice. If insincerity is apprehended on your part or disturbance is caused to others, otherwise, try to read in a loud voice, jahr. So, if there is risk of insincerity or disturbance to someone who is sleeping next to you, then recite silently, faintly. Otherwise, recite with a bit of voice, loudly. And number six, read in a melodious voice. What we mentioned in the beginning. Have a tune, develop a tune, and read with the tune. Because there are numerous ahadith laying emphasis on this. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Zayyinul Qur'ana bi aswatikum." Beautify the Quran with your voices. In another place of Tabrani, he said, "Hassinul Qur'ana bi aswatikum, fa inna as-sawta al-hasan yazidu al-Qur'ana husnan." Beautify the Quran with your voices, because beautiful voice beautifies the Quran as well. So read it with a beautiful tune, melodious voice. Rules of internal reverence. Sheikh mentions six rules of internal ruhani adab and respect. The heart should be full of the glory of the Quran, meaning realizing how sublime the Quran Pak is. Realize that Quran is amazing, it's ajeeb, it's great. So revere the Quran. Number two, bear in the heart the loftiness, majesty and magnificence of Almighty Allah, whose revelation the Quran is. So you should have the glory of Quran and also the majesty and loftiness and magnificence of Almighty Allah who sent down the Quran. Ta'zeem of Quran and ta'zeem of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Respect of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. His greatness should be instilled in our heart. Allah is great. When you read Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim Maliki Yawm Al-Din, you should have that understanding of He is Rabbul Alameen Ahkamul Hakimeen Shahinshahi Mutlaq. He is the Lord of the universe. The whole universe belongs to Him. He is the owner. He is the sovereign. He is the caretaker. He is the overseer and manager of affairs in Alameen, in all the worlds. And He is Rahman, the most merciful. Ar-Rahim, the ever merciful, the compassionate. And Maliki Yawm al-Din, He is the owner and master of the Day of Judgment. On the Day of Judgment, nobody will be able to do anything, say anything without His permission. So realize, understand the meaning of these verses and similarly other verses when they come out throughout the Quran. And three, the heart should be free from distraction and doubts. Don't let any doubts creep into your heart and mind regarding the Quran. Keep your heart free from doubt. Four, dwell upon the meanings and enjoy reading it. You know, if you know Arabic, good. If you don't know Arabic, then those words which you do understand, you know, reflect and concentrate on their meanings. Because concentrating and reflecting on meaning has an effect. this afternoon in the Yas'alunak question time, we had a question about how to focus on salah. So one of the ways of focusing on salah is to read and understand and memorize the translation of these surahs which you most often read in salah. The last 10 surahs or 20 surahs or Yasin Sharif or whatever surahs you know, learn their translation as well. And when you're reading, focus on the meaning of them. And you will be able to focus and concentrate on your salah. Number 5, submit your heart to the subject matter of the verses you are reading. For instance, an ayat containing a message of mercy, the heart should be filled with delight. And on an ayat of chastisement, azab, the heart should tremble with awe and fear. So this is the inner condition. Try to bring that condition in you. And number 6, the ears should be made as attentive as if Almighty Allah Himself is speaking and the reader is listening to Him. Meaning, don't think I am reciting. Think that Allah is reciting and I am only listening to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ajib. Shaykh Abdul Qadir Raipuri said this, as I mentioned the other day. You know, when you put the earphones, large earphones, right? You can't hear the other outside voice. You can only hear what you're listening to. And you can hear your own voice as well. This is why Qari Abdul Basit Saab, when he's reciting Quran at Tirakhirat and he wants to stretch something, he puts his hands on his ears and then he listens to himself so he can follow how he is reciting. So think for a moment that I am not reading, Allah is reading and I am listening to Him. Like Shaykh Abdul Qadir Saab said, and like Haji Imdadullah Saab said over here in Kulliyat Imdadiya. Think of yourself as Shajare Musa, the tree of Musa alayhi salam, and the voice is coming out of the tree. I am like that tree, and the voice which is coming out is Allah's voice. Allah is speaking. And then you see how much huzuri and attention and concentration you get on your tilawat. You'll have to practice for this, and slowly, you'll get to that stage. So these are 6 external adab and 6 internal adab of tilawat of Quran. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the ability to respect the Quran, to love the Quran, and to recite the Quran as much as possible. Ramzan time is Quran time. Inshallah, we will read Quran Sharif for a little bit and then we will do the dua. 10 minutes we'll read Quran and then 10 minutes we'll make dua. ठीक है जी तो अपना अपना कुरान शरीफ ले लो थोड़ी सी तिलावत कर लो इफ यू नीड टू रिसाइट ऑन हियर ऑन द मोबाइल और आईपैड यू कैन रिसाइट ऑन देयर एज वेल नो वरी आई माई सेल्फ रिसाइट इट एज वेल व्हेन आई हैव टू बट व्हेन यू कैन रीड इन द मुसहफ That is more better. What happens is, in here we remember. In Mushaf sometimes we forget. But on the mobile, you know where you exactly were. And you don't lose your nishani. ومن يريد ثواب الدنيا نؤتيه منها ومن يريد ثواب الاخره نؤتيه منها وسلم على الشيخ ابراهيم بن محمد المعروف بن كثير من خير ما اصاب من سبيل الله والله غفور سلام والله يحب صوابه ما كان الله الا ان قال ومن اخذ الله ما يسرابنا فيه من الله ثم تقدامنا ونصرنا وقوم كافرين فاتهم الله ربنا وقال الله الله يحب المحسنين يا ايها الذين امنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن الا وانتم مسلمون ربنا واتنا دعا کر لیں. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك نشهد ان لا اله الا انت نستغفرك ونتوب اليك. اللهم لك الحمد كله ولك الشكر كله ولك الملك كله بيدك الخير كله وإليك يرجع الأمر كله لا نحصي ثناء عليك أنت كما أثنيت على نفسك. اللهم لك الحمد حتى ترضى ولك الحمد بعد الرضا ولك الحمد أبدا أبدا. اللهم لك الحمد كالذي تقول وخيرا مما نقول. اللهم لك الحمد عند طرفة كل عين وتنفس كل نفس. اللهم لك الحمد كما أنت أهله ولك الشكر كما أنت أهله ولك الثناء كما أنت أهله. فصل على سيدنا محمد كما أنت أهله وافعل بنا ما أنت أهله فإنك أهل التقوى وأهل المغفرة. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد عبدك ورسولك النبي الأمي نبي الرحمة كما تحب وترضى عدد ما تحب وترضى كلما ذكره الذاكرون وكلما غفل عن ذكره الغافلون. اللهم ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. رب اغفر وارحم وأنت خير الراحمين. اللهم اغفر لنا وارحمنا وعافنا وارزقنا واسترنا واجبرنا واهدنا وارفعنا إنا لما أنزلت إلينا من خير فقراء. اللهم اغفر لجميع أمة سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم ارحم أمة سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم تجاوز عن أمة سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم استر واجبر واحفظ واهدي أمة سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم ثبتنا على الإيمان وأمتنا على الإيمان واحشرنا يوم القيامة مع المتقين مع الإيمان. اللهم حبب إلينا الإيمان وزينه في قلوبنا وكره إلينا الكفر والفسوق والعصيان واجعلنا من الراشدين واجعلنا من الفائزين المهديين واجعلنا من أهل القرآن الذين هم أهلك وخاصتك وأولياؤك يا رب العالمين. اللهم وفقنا في هذا الشهر المبارك لتلاوة كتاب الله لتلاوة القرآن الكريم وللصلاة والصيام والصدقة والأمر بالمعروف والنهي عن المنكر والذكر والتسبيح والتوبة والاستغفار ولزوم التقوى يا رب العالمين. اللهم وفقنا لما تحب وترضى من القول والعمل واجعل آخرتنا خيرا من الأولى يا رب العالمين يا أرحم الراحمين. Oh Allah, you are the most merciful, you are the most kind, you are the most forgiving. Oh Allah, we beg you for your forgiveness. We beg you for your mercy. We beg you for your kindness. Please have mercy upon us. Please forgive all our sins. Please forgive all our mistakes. Please forgive all our shortcomings. Please forgive all our disobediences. Allah, forgive our major sins, minor sins, the ones we committed in broad daylight, the ones we committed in the darkness of the night, the ones we committed in public, the ones we committed in private. Allah, wash away our sins. Cleanse us, purify us. Allah, clean and wash away the effects of sins from our hearts, the dark patches which have formed upon our hearts, the dirt and the filth which has stuck to our hearts due to our sins. Only you can wash that away. Allah, we beg you to wash it away for us. Clean us, purify us, cleanse us. Allah, give us a healthy heart. Allah, give us a clean and pure heart. Allah, give us an illuminated and a shiny heart. O Allah, give us the noor of your ma'rifat, the noor of your gnosis, the noor of your kalam-e-paak, the noor of zikr and fikr. O Allah, enlighten our hearts. Make our hearts munawwar and musaffa and mujalla and muzakka, and fill it with the roshni and the noor of iman and amali saliha and tilawat-e kalam-e-paak and zikr and tasbihat. And O Allah, allow us to stay on the right track for the rest of our lives. O Allah, give us the realization of sin as sin and to run away from it. And the realization of virtue as virtue, and the zeal to practice upon it and to head towards it. And O Allah, keep us steadfast on the Sirat Mustaqim till the day we die. Give us the noor of your Iman, the noor of your Ma'rifat. Give us the halawat and sweetness of Iman, O Allah, and keep us steadfast on Sirat Mustaqim. Have mercy upon us, fulfill our needs. O Allah, fulfill all our needs. O Allah, forgive us and forgive our parents, our mothers and our sisters and brothers. O Allah, everyone at home, forgive the Muslims of our town, this locality. Forgive all the Muslims of our country. Forgive all the Muslims of the whole world. Forgive all our marhumeen in their graves. O Allah, forgive each and every single Muslim. Have mercy upon the Muslim community around the whole world. And O Allah, grant them the ability to turn towards you and to seek forgiveness from you and to do tawbah and repent from all lies of disobediences and sinning. O Allah, allow us to draw ourselves closer to you and attach ourselves to you and to your kalam-e-paak and to Quran-e-Majeed. Give us the love of Quran-e-Majeed. Give us the love of tilawat and recitation, and give us the beauty and the lazzat and the halawat and the sweetness of tilawat e kalam. And O Allah, fulfill our needs. Those who are not well among us, our elders, our parents, our relatives, O Allah, give them shifa. Those who have been struck by this COVID-19, O Allah, give them shifa. Have mercy upon them. O Allah, cure them. Give them complete and lasting shifa. And those who have died in this illness or with other reasons, O Allah, shower your rahmah and mercy upon their graves. Elevate their ranks in Jannah. Forgive them. Make their graves gardens from the gardens of Jannah. Expand their graves for them. Give them noor in their graves. And O Allah, protect them from the azab of qabr, and protect them from the testing and the tests of the qabr, and have mercy upon them. And O Allah, around the world, wherever Muslims are in whatever distress and problem, remove their distress and problems for them. O Allah, because of this afat and bala which has come upon us, many people have become redundant, many people have lost jobs, many people have suffered in their businesses. O Allah, replace their loss for them, and give us, O Allah, rizqi halal with lots of barakah. O Allah, our masajid, madaris might be suffering due to loss of collection, O Allah, and fundings. Help them. Help all the madaris and all the masajid around this country and around the whole world, and take care of them. Fulfill their needs for them. Take care of everyone, every Muslim, young and old, around the whole world. Take care of our ulama, sulaha, mashayikh, Ahlullah, our relatives, our elders, our peers. Take care of all those who are working for your deen, Tabligh Jamaat, wherever they are. Maybe they are trapped somewhere. O Allah, provide relief and ease for them. Those students and talaba who are trapped in some madaris, unable to travel around, especially in India. O Allah, make their lives easy for them. And O Allah, for all Muslims around the whole world, especially Muslims where they are suffering and going through tough time, in Arab or non-Arab lands, in Rohingya, Burma, and wherever, O Allah, you know our conditions. O Allah, please provide relief for our Muslim brothers and sisters around the whole world. Protect Haramain Sharifain, protect Masjid Aqsa, and accept our humble du'as. Accept all the du'as which we made throughout the month of Ramadan, and we give us the ability to make lots and lots and lots of nice du'as throughout the month of Ramadan. O Allah, we don't even know how to make du'as. Our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam made the most beautiful du'as from you. We ask you to give us all those good things which your beloved Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked from you, and protect us from all those evils, trials, tribulations, problems, sicknesses, fitnas from which he sallallahu alaihi wasallam sought your protection. 2 minute ke liye apni dua mang le.
ربنا تقبل منا انك انت السميع العليم وتب علينا انك انت التواب الرحيم وصلي اللهم وسلم على سيدنا محمد وعلى اله وصحبه اجمعين برحمتك يا ارحم الراحمين.